Okay, so I just got my meal packs from Backpacker's Pantry. All of these are vegan, so I just wanted to give them a try. So on Mondays and Tuesdays for dinner, I'm going to be having one of these. I'm going to figure out what I like. And then, then I'll know what to order more of for our trips up the Stikine River or during the summer. Got all these little fellows. A bunch of pad thais, because I know I like the pad thai. Plus, I ended up getting some of the oatmeals because I just thought I'd try them. I think they're a little expensive for just quick oats, but yeah, we'll give these guys a try. Okay, first up, I'm eating the Cuban coconut black beans and rice. Black beans, rice, coconut, banana. Okay, so I'm boiling some water. You're supposed to pull out a little packet. Keeps things dry or whatever. Remove and discard oxygen absorber. Add 1½ cups of boiling water. Stir well, seal pouch, wait 8 minutes. Stir again, reseal, wait 7 minutes more. Enjoy! These are the ingredients. These are the particulars. 15 minutes later, this is what it looks like. Let's see if we can get a closer look here. Bananas. Oh, it's all steamy. Okay, so let's give this a try with a little spoon. Okay, I'm gonna do a scale of 1 to 5, 5 being the best, 1 being the not good. And I'm gonna give this a 3.5 because I really like the flavor, but it's a little bland. It could have some sort of spiciness to it or something, or some sort of different flavor in there. I really like the difference between the kind of bean flavor and the sweet banana flavor. It's really nice, and I really like it actually. But since I want to give myself room in case there's a really, really good variety, then I'm going to give it a 3.5. Today, I am doing 3 bean veggie stew. Pinto beans, red beans, chickpeas, vegetables, and hemp seeds. Oh, yeah. Ingredients and nutritional facts. Whoa, can you see them? There you go. Nutritional facts. Okay, here we go. Trying the 3 bean veggie stew. Wow, this one's really good. It's spicy, but not too spicy. The flavor is really good. I like the mix of beans and vegetables. I'm inclined to give it a 5, but I'm not going to. I'm gonna give it a 4 because there might be something else that's spectacular. But I'm definitely gonna buy this one again. I already know that. I really like it. Yeah. I don't know, 4.5. Kathmandu curry. Lentil, rice, potatoes, peas, carrots, and curry spices. Ingredients. And nutritional facts. Nice curry spices. Not too spicy. Not spicy enough. Yummy peas that you run into every once in a while. Just really good. Another 4.5. 3 Sisters Southwestern quinoa and beans. Brown rice, quinoa, corn, black beans, zucchini, and hatch green chilies. Ingredients and nutritional facts. You can see the zucchini and the little corn bits, which are nice. Pepper's in here somewhere. It's nice, spicy, not too spicy again. You know, this is really good. I really like it, but maybe it's not quite as good as the others. So maybe I'll give it a 4.0. It's got lime in it and you can taste it. And it's just really good. I don't know. Do we give this a 4.5? Mango, sticky rice, mango, coconut, black sesame seeds. This is a smaller pack than normal. Ingredients. Nutritional facts. Only one cup of water in this guy. Check it out. You can see the little sesame seeds in there. Kind of mild mango flavor. And then it tastes really mango-y when you run into a mango. Oh, there's a mango. Oh, that's really good. But it does taste like dessert. I don't know if I'd want to eat this for like some sort of meal, like a full, like a meal. I'll give it a dessert 4. Oh. Okay, folks, so this morning I spy-bocked my bread. This was supposed to be toast for breakfast. So I'm going to eat this blueberry walnut oats instead. I just need one cup of water. Rolled oats, quinoa, blueberries, walnuts, and hemp seeds. What's with all this quinoa stuff? Ingredients, nutritional facts. 5 minutes. We have whole walnuts in here. and blueberries. I mean, it's just oatmeal. It's just oatmeal. Did I already say that? I don't know, it's kind of boring. You can kind of taste the quinoa, I think. Which I don't know, it's a little weird. I mean, maybe it makes it a little less boring than regular oatmeal. I'll give it a 3. I mean, it's not fantastic, but it's good. Yeah. Oh boy. Okay, folks, so today is camping food day, and I'm on to Louisiana red beans and rice. This is another one of the little packs. Louisiana red beans and rice, red beans, rice, tomato, and Cajun-inspired seasoning. Ingredients, nutritional facts. I'm back. It's good, and the spices are good. Again, not too hot, not too mild. But there's no doodads in this one like some of the other meal packs, which make them really kind of interesting. So it's a little boring, but it's good. So I'll give it a 3. Breakfast and lunch were both a 3. Okie doke, chai masala, chickpeas, rice, coconut milk, tomato, and turmeric. Ingredients and nutrition facts. Chickpeas. Ooh, that's a little spicy. Of all their meals, this is the spiciest to me. Ooh, that's a little spicy. Maybe almost a little too spicy for me, but for other people, it would not be spicy at all. Okay, now that I've been chewing on this for a little while, it's also almost a little too salty. So I'm gonna give it a 3, maybe 2.75 even. 2.5, I don't know. Okay, dudes, so peanut butter and banana oatmeal. I don't know, it's just oatmeal. It's a little sweet, a little bit boring, a little bit sweet for me. I'll give it a 3. Okie dokie, late dinner. This is the last of my meal packs. I've just got one more oatmeal to try. Of course, I've tried the pad thai before, like I said before. Yes, last one.
rice noodles, vegetables, peanuts, and sriracha lime sauce. It comes with another peanut butter pack, like this morning's oatmeal, and some peanuts. Ingredients, nutritional facts. Like with the oatmeal this morning, you're supposed to squeeze in the peanut butter first, and then you put the hot water in with it and mix it around. That's how that works. And the peanuts go in after everything's done. Okay, I know that this doesn't look very appetizing, but I love this. It's so good.
So the noodles are, you know, they're not perfect. It's not like what you get at a restaurant. Man, the flavor is just so good. I love this one. I'm gonna give it a 5. This is my absolute favorite. This is so good. You can taste the lime in there, and it's spicy, and you can taste the peanuts and the peanut butter, and it's just like so good. It just looks like mush, that's all. Okay, dudes, so I ate the last pack, cinnamon apple oats, and it's fine, it's oatmeal, and the apples are just a little bit sour, but at least it wasn't too sweet. Yeah, I don't know, it's just oatmeal. I'll give it a 3. Okay, so that is my assessment of Backpackers Pantry meals. I like a lot of them, but I don't know that I'll get them this year because I still have 3 pad thais left. And we don't eat a lot of these meals when we're on our jet boat going up the Stikine River. We will just eat them like if we're in a hurry and we're in the middle of driving for us to stop for a quick lunch, or maybe sometimes I'll even have something for breakfast if we're trying to get out of somewhere and get going. Otherwise, we, you know, kind of bring our own stuff and make food because that's kind of part of the fun. So, like, we'll bring some veggie hamburgers and hot dogs and kind of do something like that for like dinners. And for breakfast, we'll bring potatoes and garlic and stuff like that and chop it up and make a hash in the morning. So I don't need that many. But yeah, and so I wouldn't want to get more from this company when it costs a lot for shipping. So I would want to just kind of do another order next year and get a bunch of them, because I really like some of them. I'm tempted actually to get more of them right now because I really like some of them, especially like that mango rice thingy, which was really good. Like, I kind of like to eat that for breakfast or something. And also some of the stews and stuff I just thought were really good. So anyway, if not this year, next year for sure, I'm going to get more of those. So one thing about this company is that most of their ingredients are not organic. There are some of their oatmeals, they have some organic ingredients in them, but otherwise not. And so not a big deal. It's not like I'm gonna die from pesticide residue or something from a few meals in a year. Or, you know, that I'm not supporting organic farmers or something like that, you know, with just a few meals. But I was looking at Mary Jane's farm. They have some backpacking food that we've eaten in the past, but a lot of it has dairy in it. When I was vegetarian, I would eat that. And so I might order those just to have a variety this year, and then review those vegan and organic from Mary Jane Farm. So anyway, yes, that is my meal review. It was fun learning some different options that I like. And hopefully folks that go backpacking or camping or whatever might have some options then too, and know what at least I liked. And yeah, check out some of my boat videos when we take our jet boat up the Stikine River this last year in 2023. The summer we went up into Canada again, and this time we went up the Porcupine River, kind of got stuck, and then came back down. and then looking for the Scud River, but it was really blocked with a lot of trees and stuff. So next year we're gonna take our aluminum jet boat plus the puffy rubber boat. We'll go inside the aluminum boat, we'll take it up, and because the puffy rubber boat can go through really shallow stuff and rocks. It can bounce around rocks and it won't get damaged. So check those videos out. And yes, bye.